joining me this morning from Live Companies, David Ciclitira. David, morning.
Good morning to you.
Look, building on your recent momentum, quite an exciting announcement this morning, the launch here of Bricklive Tutankhamun. Tell us a bit more, David.
Well, this is our first super tour. It's a tour that I think will do really well. As our RNS says, November 1922, Howard Carter discovered Tutankhamun. So not so far, what are we talking about? 2 years' time, it's the 100th anniversary. And I think if you were to look that week on Time magazine or wherever it is, you will find tremendous imagery of Tutankhamun. It's one of those things you just know is going to go global. There is an actual show which is running now, and it was actually in the Saatchi Gallery till lockdown. It was in Paris, did record numbers, 200,000 visitors, etc. It's going on to Tokyo, it's been in Los Angeles. So this is obviously real relics from the Tutankhamun too. But so many people would love to see it. Lots of venues have tried to get hold of this show. It costs an absolute fortune to run. And so there is even a replica Tutankhamun show, which is running at the current time. So this gave me the idea that we should try and create a Bricklive Tutankhamun. Now, obviously it's educational. That's important for kids, but kids want fun. So I have to say, it's a bit like Tutankhamun meets the mummy. You remember the movie? So it's got a bit of fun and a lot of moving parts and things that are correct in this time of COVID. So not lots of interaction, but basically lots of interest for kids. We've just put out a week ago feelers to our network. We've got an interest already from our German partner to look at a year's tenancy starting next autumn, which is obviously very interesting. We're talking to some people already to potentially launch this in the UK in June and next year. So I'm very, very keen on this project. And we call it a super tour because it's the biggest thing we've done, I think, in terms of business, in terms of the models, and in terms of everything about it, really.
So launching in summer 2021, and you describe this as a rather immersive experience.
Yes, it's walking through with backdrops, information, things that move, slightly scary things. So you all remember the movie with the scarabs running up the wall and all that sort of stuff. But it is basically Tutankhamun. And as I said, we put out last week some flyers, some a short video, and we got tremendous reaction. So for the first time, we've got mainstream British museums talking to us, wanting to be involved. And I think this will, in the main, probably be a museum show. But the people in Germany have got it locked into an entertainment area. So frankly, it's very big news for us because in this, a lot of our shareholders are wondering, you know, what's going to happen? Is this company valid, I guess? Well, you'll see there's a second part of the announcement today. Another show sold starting next week, running to the end of October. But this Tutankhamun is a special thing. It's everybody knows us for the dinosaurs, the brachiosaurs that we built. And I think that's up there even more. So I think early next year, we'll probably be able to announce, before it's finished, that a complete two-year path of where it's going to go and everything. And the merchandising opportunities are very big as well because we can make kits, obviously small kits. I think the imagery, there is an initial sort of image poster out there. So I think T-shirts, everything. I think it's going to be really good for the company and really, really take us to another level.
And good for the company, fairly lucrative from a revenue perspective, you'd expect.
Yes, the prices we're talking about are of the same scale as Bricosaurs, which is kind of £50,000 a month. That's without sharing. I think this one we will want to have some profit share on top. So I think that I just feel it's 2 years of very good revenue. And also it's all about putting us back on the map. I've spoken to you before how I believe that 21 will be a great year followed by an even better year in 22. Obviously now it's very tough in the UK. Perception is everything. And you know, you've got the Chancellor arguing with his colleagues, saying we've got to keep stuff open, and I'm sure he's going to win through. So this is anyway for next May, June. So,
well, let's just have another quick word, David, on this new contract that you've secured with Inverary Castle in Scotland. It's the first time you've partnered with them.
Yes, and I think it's a small project. It's a Fantasy Kingdom, which is, you know, is the dragons and stuff. And I think that, again, shows Paddington last week, that this week. I think we're about, well, last year we did 71 events. I'm confident that we will hit 30 this year, possibly go past that. And when you think that 6 months of this year, the peak time, we were not active, I think that would be a very credible result, and lead on to a very good number of events for 2021.
Good to see you this morning, David. Thanks very much.
Thank you so much.